In this video, I'm going to show you how to add and customize an audio player section on your website. This is great if you're a musician and you want to showcase your music on your site, or you have a podcast and want to host clips of your podcast on your website. So right now I'm on the website builder, and here's a template I started with my account. If I want to add an audio player section, I can just hover on the editor. For example, if I want to add the section below this one here, just click Add Section. Choose audio player and select the layout that you like. So now it's added the section below that one. On this section, you can edit everything just by clicking on it right here, or look for the corresponding labels on the left. So an audio player section comes with a title, description, an album cover, and different audio tracks. If you don't want to see any of these items as part of the section, you can toggle them off. But I'm going to leave them all on. Now let's go ahead and edit the text. So you can click right on the editor and edit right here, or again, you can edit on the left. If you edit on the left, you'll notice that there are more options for styling the text. For example, under description, this text editor has more options. So if you highlight the text, you can make it bold, italicized, underlined. You can also add lists. And you can also add links to your text. I'll get rid of that. For example, if I want to make this a link, just highlight it and then click the link to icon right here. And now you can choose to link to something within your website or to an external site. So I'm going to link this text to my Spotify account. So I'll choose web address. And now you can add the Spotify URL right here. And because this is an external site, I'm going to have it open in a new window. So click that and then click Save. So now I've added a link. You can also play around with the text alignment. Just highlight it. So now we can go ahead and change the album cover, which is right here. So you can upload and change it directly or select from files. So I'll click that option. And you can see if you have some images that you've already uploaded that you can change the album cover to. You can click this to upload a file from your computer. But for this video, I'm going to choose a stock image. So under Explore, I'll choose Stock Images. And you can look through the categories here. Click Save. Now you can choose whether the image fits or fills the image container. So fill will ensure that the entire image container is filled, but it may crop the image depending on the aspect ratio. And fit will ensure that the entire image is shown, but you may see some white space, again, depending on the aspect ratio of the image. And you can also play around with the positioning. Now you'll notice that this section comes with individual blocks. And when you select one of the blocks, you'll see that each block has its own set of options that you can customize. So for example, if I'm editing this one right here, you can change the media, which is the audio file. You can add a track cover. Right now it's toggled off. I could toggle that on and then upload an image, so I'll toggle that on. And you can also add a title and artist name. So first we'll change the file. So under Media, just click this pencil icon. And I've already uploaded some audio files to my file manager. But you can go ahead and upload a file again by clicking Upload File right here. Make sure that there are audio file types like MP3 and WAV. Just a note, you can see the maximum number of hours of audio that can be uploaded depending on your plan right here. So I've already uploaded some tracks, so I'll click on this one right here and then click Save. So now you'll see that I've added the new track. I'll go ahead and change the title and artist name. The title is correct, I'll just change the artist name. And just to show you what it looks like, I'll change the cover as well. So I'm going to select from files. And again, you can upload your own images, but I'm going to choose another stock image. So now I've edited this entire audio track block. If you want to add or remove music track blocks, you can click back right here so we can go back to the audio player section overview. And now we'll scroll on the left and you'll see the list of the audio tracks. So for example, if I want to delete this one, just hover on it and then click this pencil icon and click delete. So now I've removed that track. If you want to add a track, just click Add Audio Track, and it's been added. We'll go back to the overview again, and I'll also show you how to rearrange the order of your tracks. So for example, there are two ways to do this. I can hover on the track and then click Edit and move it up or down, or you can click and drag on the left of the track names and rearrange it like that. If you want to change any of the styling options for this section, we'll scroll up on the left and then choose Change Colors and Layout. And as a side note, if you want to change the colors or fonts on your website, we have video tutorials to show you how to do that. But if you just want to change the colors for this section specifically, just click Change Colors right here. And you can pick from the site theme colors or choose custom colors. So we'll go back. And you'll see that there are more styling options that you can play around with here. We'll go back to the overview again. So now we're going to go to the preview. So this is what visitors will see. You'll see if visitors click on the track, it will be showcased at the top along with the track cover or album cover. And visitors can play or pause the music using the controls here. When you're ready to take everything live, make sure you click Publish on the top right corner. So that's it for this video. As you can see, it's very easy to make your own website and customize it entirely for your needs using the Site Builder. Thanks for watching and good luck on your website building journey.